Hey folks, this is Best in Slot, and in tonight's Jurassic World Evolution 2 analysis video, we're going to do a dig site analysis. Was that dramatic? It's meant to be. What that means is we're going to take a look at every single dig site that was available in the preview version of the game that I played and you saw last week. We're going to look at what dinosaurs and other creatures now used to live in that dig site, and what other dinosaurs and other new species could potentially also live in those dig sites. A lot of these will be returns from the first game, but there are several brand new ones to take a look at as well. And even when they return, that doesn't mean there aren't going to be new dinosaurs there, so we'll speculate on that a little bit as well. I'll show you all that in a second. One thing I do want to say very quickly, unlike last time, it does appear that Frontier has hidden a bunch of dig sites from us. For example, there are no dig sites in Africa in the version of the game that I played, and that obviously won't be the case when Evolution 2 comes out. So that's interesting, to say the least. I think they're onto us a little bit, but we'll do the best with what we can. Let's get started. There's a lot to cover. I'm going to be pretty snappy throughout, hopefully. So this is how it's going to work. First dig site I clicked, Scollard Formation up in Canada in the Great White North. That was one from the last game, so this is what it contained. Ankylosaurus, Chasmosaurus, Corythosaurus, and Pachycephalosaurus. Now the Scollard Formation could of course make it into Evolution 2 in that exact same form. All four of those dinosaurs are actually confirmed for Evolution 2, so this could be identical. But that wouldn't be very fun, so for all of these ones I've picked what I would think would be the most likely species to be added from that formation. So for example, for the Scollard Formation, Thescalosaurus, this one from the beautiful Saurian piece of art, I think would be a pretty popular choice. It's a relatively well-known dinosaur, definitely not as obscure as some of the other ones we've got so far already. And I think it would be a good choice to add in if they felt the need to add something to the Scollard Formation. The first few are all going to be like that. So for example, we're back to Dinosaur Park Formation. That one had a ton of dinosaurs in the first game, joint most with a few other dig sites, absolutely tons of the bloody things. But if we were going to add a new species, Lambeosaurus is a very, very popular requested creature. The late Cretaceous Hadrosaurid, you know, we've had mods for it in Evolution 1. Lots of people want to see Lambeo, mainly because it's got this weird axe shape for a crest. It makes it very unique amongst the Hadrosaurids, and I think they could do something pretty cool with that. Moving on to the Frenchman Formation, also in the Great White North. This time I really couldn't find another creature that I felt was even somewhat likely. So Thescalosaurus, again, would be my pick. You've got to remember, a lot of these creatures could appear in multiple different formations across the map. Hell Creek, possibly the most famous dig site of all time, contained quite a few different dinosaurs, as you can see. But if you're going to chuck another one in, just to go back to Saurian one more time, the Cotoraptor seems like a pretty good bet, a pretty popular bet. There's one thing I tried to do a couple of times, and that was take an existing grouping, like say Dromosaurids, bring in a new species that could potentially show off a little bit of feathering, if we were ever going to get that in Jurassic World Evolution 2. So you'll see it here with the Cotoraptor, and you'll see it a little bit later on. Further to the southeast, we have the Fox Hills Formation, and if you don't remember that name, that's because it's brand new, as you can see by the very happy Jeff Goldblum at the bottom. Now, Fox Hills was a massive pain in the ass. There's very little information out there about Fox Hills. It is very much entrapped by many other much more popular dig sites, some like Hell Creek, etc., and other ones that we'll see throughout this video. My best guess is that it will be a second dig site for Mosasaurus. There's another dig site we'll get to later on, which I think is more popular and better known for the Mosasaurus, but Mosasaurus hoffmanni, which is, I suspect, the species we're going for here, as it's the larger species of Mosasaurus, it has been discovered in Fox Hills, and I really couldn't find anything else that seemed likely. There's a dubious Plesiosaur urinatus or something like that, could maybe, I guess, but I suspect what it is we've got two different Mosasaurus formations, and this is the North American one, and we've got another one in Europe. To the southwest, we have Pierre Shale. This was in the last game with Pteranodon, but I suspect it may get a little bit of a boost because along with several other dig sites, we'll see Elasmosaurus was found in Pierre Shale as well. And Elasmosaurus is a pretty good bet, I would suggest, still for a large Plesiosaur if we're going to get one of those in Jurassic World Evolution 2. another hyper-populated dig site in the Lance Formation. As you can see, many, many dinosaurs scrambled their way in here. And we're going back to Saurian, once again for Ornithomimus. So again, like with the Dakota Raptor, where I thought it was a nice idea for a feathered Dromaeosaurid, maybe the Ornithomimus comes in, along with our, you know, our Gallimimus and our Archaeornithomimus, etc. And that becomes our feathered variant, basically, of that same grouping. I think that'd be a pretty nice little idea. Further to the west, we have Dinosaur National Monument, which contained Apatosaurus, Camarasaurus, Diplodocus, Stegosaurus, bloody Nora. And this was a little bit of a touch and go on this, but Camptosaurus from Path of Titans there, nice little pick there, well done Rebecca Slater. Mid-sized Late Jurassic, I called it a basal iguanodontid, I suppose basal is probably not technically the right term, but it was very early in the split before iguanodontids really came into the picture, so. Camptosaurus, pretty popular dinosaur as well, relatively well known. I suspect that one is definitely one of the ones that will be left as it is. Heading a little south to Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry, we have a few more dinosaurs right there. And this little middle bit's a little bit down in the dumps, I'm not gonna lie. But Stegosaurus again is, I wouldn't say well known, but moderately popular. It's an early Tyrannosaurid. It's always cool to have new Tyrannosaurids and Tyrannosaurids of different sizes in particular, I think is an interesting thing. I think people hear Tyrannosaurid and they think Rex. It's nice to mix that up a little bit. Something the game is already doing with one of its other inclusions, it must be said. And in a similar vibe to these last couple ones, the Morrison Formation again had a ton of dinosaurs. You know, this game loves North America. Dinosaurs in particular love North America, so lots of ones there. Saurophaganax though would be a very popular choice. I'm not quite sure why Saurophaganax is so popular. It has an awesome name, but beyond that, it is basically just an Allosaurus. So I don't know why it's so hyper popular and requested, although I like it because of the name, and I think it isn't a particularly unlikely dinosaur. We also have the Caparowitz, there we go, formation, which, as you can see, contains Nasutoceratops, Interesting little point I want to very quickly point out. These dinosaurs all started at 50%. There was no growing them from 0 to 100. It was 50 to 100. So with something later on, I'll bring this back up again. I actually hatched it without ever getting a fossil. I did not realize this at all during my playthrough. This would have made my life a lot easier. Anyways, Nasutoceratops, so if we wanted to extend that a little bit, and I quite like this as a choice, Teratophonius, a mid-sized Late Cretaceous Tyrannosaurid. Again, another Tyrannosaurid, another theropod. People love those, people go hype for the theropods in particular. But Teratophonius, as you're seeing from this picture here, was of course in Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. It was dead, but it would be a nice way to A, extend this very, very empty formation, and B, bring in a little bit of canon goodness into Evolution 2. I'd keep an eye on this one. I think this is maybe not for release, but overall a solid bet, I would say. To the southeast, we have Ghost Ranch, one of the coolest names for a dig site ever. As you can see, it contains Coelophysis, although only at 0% for this one, so never mind what I said a moment ago. And it is brand new. Jeff Goldblum has returned. After looking at it, I mean, Ghost Ranch is very well known for Coelophysis. There are tons of them in there, all just in this pit. And I suspect Ghost Ranch will remain just Coelophysis. So we'll move on from that one. Down to Garden Park, well known for its sauropods. We've got Brachiosaurus and Diplodocus. Really couldn't find anything standing out for this one. But the next one, in Smoky Hill Chalk, contained Pteranodon. So this was a Return to Jurassic Park edition back in the last game. But it also contains, Smoky Hill Chalk was basically this big, flat, shallow ocean back then. It also contains Tylosaurus, which I think is a pretty damn good bet to make it into Jurassic World Evolution 2 in the base game. I suspect they want to reuse that Mosasaurus rig a little bit. Tylosaurus would come in, reuse the exact same rig, but maybe just be a little bit smaller than the Mosasaurus, basically. Of course, would be an immensely popular choice. This one, out of all of the subjective, like speculative creatures on this list, I think this is the best bet. I would be surprised if Tylo doesn't make it in. And another new formation, we have the Neobara Formation. He's just so happy. Tylosaurus and Elasmosaurus were both found here, so they could definitely be included. But another popular choice, definitely a highly speculated addition, would be Nyctosaurus, a pterosaur, Late Cretaceous Nyctosaurid, oddly enough. Well known for its absolutely, utterly bizarre crest, would be a really cool addition to Jurassic World Evolution 2. Maybe some clipping issues here and there, but it's a creature I think a lot of us would love to see added to the game. We're finally moving away from North America now, heading over to Portugal and the Laringha Formation, which in the past game contained Ceratosaurus and Stegosaurus. And I believe there was something else here, and I was meant to write it down, I didn't. That seems very likely to come from here. And I can't remember what it was, but I went for Miragaia anyway. I think this would be a pretty cool Stegosaurid. It looks a little different. Well known for having the longest neck of any Stegosaurid that ever existed. I mean, that thing is half bloody giraffe, so that would be a pretty nice addition to the game. Moving across the channel, back to good old Blighty here in the UK, which will contain a lot of species in this game, I'm telling you. We have the Oxford Clay Formation, which in the last game included Metriacanthosaurus, but in this game, probably contains the same, don't get me wrong, but could also contain Leopleurodon, which is a Middle Jurassic Plesiosaur. Now, I am not putting money on it. There's a couple of other options, say Chronosaurus and stuff like that. I think Leopleurodon has a pretty bloody good chance of making it into Evolution 2. I don't have the image to hand, but someone showed an image of the medium-sized aquatic species, basically. So we've had the small, like say the Ichthyosaurus, we've had the larger, like the Mosasaurus, but the icon for the middle one looks like a short-necked plesiosaur, i.e. a plesiosaur. As you can see here, the neck is much shorter, he's much thicker in general. Now this Leopleurodon is massively oversized. It's well known for being massively oversized. In reality, Leopleurodon was about 20 feet or so long, and here it's like a billion. It's got Jurassic World Mosasaurus syndrome. But it fits the look of the icon, it's around the right size. It would be on the low size for medium, I would say, but it's around the right size. It would be a very popular choice, it's well known, you know, from Walking with Dinosaurs, Cruel Seas, etc. Leopleurodon, also a good bet in my opinion. Also in the UK, we have another new dig site. We have the Jurassic Coast. There's little Goldblum, he's frilled. And I think this one was pretty obvious. Ichthyosaurus and Plesiosaurus are both likely to come from this Jurassic Coast formation. The Marianing doublet there. I'm sure there might be a couple more shoved in there eventually. You know, the Jurassic Coast and this kind of, that whole Dorset area was very, very popular for marine species discoveries, and people get a little annoyed. I quite like that Frontier sort of celebrates their home nation a little bit. You know, I think that's kind of cute in a way. You know, shove them all in. I want every single species in here. Back over the channel to the Netherlands, we have the Maastricht Formation, which I was convinced was in the last game for some reason. But there we go, it is brand new, and I think this is really the dig site where Mosasaurus is most well known. Mosasaurus hofmanni. The Mosasaurus in Jurassic World is actually a made-up species called Mosasaurus maximus, but it is largely based on hofmanni. Hofmanni? Hofmoir? I don't know if you put it hofmanni, hofmanni. Something like that. Anyways, she has returned, and I suspect this is definitely a Mosasaurus dig site. Now heading across the world to Brazil with the Romualdo Formation, the very first Brazilian dig site we've ever had in Jurassic World Evolution. So to celebrate that fact, Jeff Goldblum has thrown an absolute party. Now unfortunately, we kind of probably know what this is already. As it says at the very top, Ceratodactylus, which is confirmed to be in the game, did come from this formation, so it's very likely. However, a boy can dream. Irritator, this art is Anthony James Hutchings sells this art online, definitely go check it out. It is a stunning piece of work of this Irritator, a small early Cretaceous Spinosaurid. I think that'd be a really cool thing to include, especially if it looked like this. So, although I think it might just be Ceratodactylus, you know, they can't add all the dig sites for just one species. You know, sometimes they're going to throw two or three in there, so we live in hope. The one dig site I didn't click but did actually spot whilst reviewing this footage is the Lacolonia Formation, which contains Carnotaurus and basically nothing else. Now, off to Asia, we have the Iron Dabasu Formation, which contains Archaeonothamimus and Velociraptor, but another popular choice in the Gigantoraptor, this late Cretaceous ginormous Oviraptorid. And of course, we had a mod for this by Nanolicensis in Jurassic World Evolution. Jurassic World Evolution kind of neglected Oviraptorids entirely, right? I don't think any made it into the game, so given we know there's an Oviraptor in the Dominion IMAX preview, so it's probably going to make it in someday, it would be nice to see a little bit of this put into the game. Maybe they were worried they'd have to add an egg feeder, but we know they ate other things, they definitely don't need to do that. I don't know what the reason is, but it's definitely an area I'd like to see them explore a little bit more. And why not Gigantoraptor? You know, we need more big weird herbivores. Speaking of big weird herbivores, we have the Nemet Formation, which is known for, you know, Velociraptor, Gallimimus, stuff like that. But does contain another dinosaur there are rumours about, to say the least, and that is, of course, Therizinosaurus. Possibly the single most requested dinosaur in the entire game. You know, a lot of what Frontier have done for Evolution 2 is listen to fan feedback and integrate those changes. Now, I think there's a little bit of concern about the feathering and about them biting that bullet. I don't know why, I think most of us were thrilled with it, but I don't want a naked Therizinosaurus, okay? I just don't. So please, a feathered Therizinosaurus would be awesome. That would be amazing. If not now, then, you know, maybe with the future DLC, blah, 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 blah. Final formation. No idea how I'm going to pronounce that one. Nanjong, something like that. Which is another brand new formation. Jeff has ascended now. He's reached his final form. And it really is notable for one thing in particular. Our Quanju, I think that's how you pronounce it, Quanju, something like that. Quanjusaurus, which is, of course, our Tyrannosaurid that we've already seen and fallen in love with, basically. Anyways, that is about it, ladies and gentlemen. I'm a little optimistic that some of these suggestions will make it in. I think Tylosaurus, Elasmosaurus, Leopleurodon for the aquatics are all... Yeah, I don't think all of them are going to make it in, but I think I'd be surprised if one of those three does not make it into the game. And if I had to bet, I think Leopleurodon or Kronosaurus and Tylosaurus, I think Tylosaurus is the best bet. But there are many, many possibilities out there. I would love to hear your thoughts and dreams and queries and suggestions and all that kind of malarkey. Let me know in the comment section down below. We'll probably end up doing this again in the future if we can see some more dig sites down the line. Or maybe we'll do like a little update or something. But I suspect this might be all the information we get till release now. Because release is only a couple of months away. And a week-ish. Week and a half and a couple of months. It's creeping up. Thank you so much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much love as always. Bye-bye.